Hello friends, in the previous video we have seen product of inertia. See, in this video one more important topic, that is principal axis and principal moment of inertia. What is meant by principal axis and principal moment of inertia? Just see some points. The axis about which the product of inertia is zero is called as principal axis. Again, here I am repeating this sentence. The axis about which the product of inertia is zero is called as principal axis. See, already I have taken problem on product of inertia. Already I explained what is the product of inertia. The axis about which the product of inertia is zero is called as principal axis. Here, the moment of inertia about principal axis is called as the principal moment of inertia. There are two principal axes mutually perpendicular to each other. The moment of inertia about one axis will be maximum and the other axis will be minimum. The principal axis about which the principal axis about which moment of inertia is maximum and it's called as a major principal moment of inertia. The principal axis about which the moment of inertia is called as minor principal moment of inertia. See, formula for major principal moment of inertia is equal to Ixx plus Iyy divided by 2 plus under root of in bracket Ixx minus Iyy divided by 2 bracket complete square plus Ixy square. Here minor principal moment of inertia is equal to Ixx plus Iyy divided by 2 minus under root of in bracket Ixx minus Iyy divided by 2 whole bracket complete square plus Ixy square. You can see the formula. The formulas are very important. You can note down both the formulas. So many times in the university exam they are asking major principal moment of inertia and minor principal moment of inertia. Already I explained you the definition. See, the one more important point, what is the location of principal axis? So location is tan 2 theta is equal to 2 Ixy upon Iyy minus Ixx. So the formulas are given. So many times in the university question paper, they are asking problem on principal moment of inertia. See, this is the problem from May 2015 for 10 marks. You can see this one is a L section. See the problem. An area in the form of L section as shown in figure. Find the moment of inertia Ixx, then Iyy and Ixy about its centroidal axis. Also determine the principal moment of inertia. See, this problem is for 10 marks. Already you know how to calculate the moment of inertia about xx axis and about yy axis. Also, I have taken the problem on Ixy, that is product of inertia. Here the important point, that is principal moment of inertia. See, this one is the given diagram. Base is given, that is 100. Depth is given 10 for first rectangle. This one is a vertical rectangle. For the vertical rectangle, the dimensions are given total height is given, that is 150, and this distance is given, that is 10 mm. So you can see, you have to divide the given diagram. You have to locate first x-axis. Generally, we are taking baseline as a x-axis, that vertical line as a y-axis. Here you can see, for this problem, we have taken this one as a first area, that is first rectangle, and this one as a second rectangle. See, dimensions are given. So here, according to our regular position, if we have to calculate the area for first rectangle, base is given, that is 100, depth is given, that is 10. So area 1 is equal to 100 into 10, that is 1000 mm square. For area 2, now this dimension is 140, this dimension is 10. You know that B into D, that is 140 into 10, that is 1400 mm square. All dimensions are in mm, so area will be in mm square. So again, we have to calculate x1, x2, y1 and y2. Already we studied in the engineering mechanics, so here I am directly taking the values. For first, the distance from x-axis, that is distance from base, centroid point will be here, that is 10 by 2, the answer will be 5 mm. X1 distance, that is 100 by 2, that is 50 mm. So x1 is equal to 50 mm. Y2, for this, the y2 will be 10, this distance is 10, 10 plus 140 divided by 2, that is 140 divided by 2 plus 10, that is 80 mm. So y2 will be 80 mm and x1 will be, again, from vertical axis, this one is a vertical axis, this distance is 10. So the centroid point will be here, that is 10 by 2, that is 5 mm. We know that how to calculate x bar and y bar. While calculating y bar, the value will be a1, formula will be a1 into y1 plus a2 into y2 upon summation of all the areas, that is a1 plus a2. Here we have the value of a1, y1, a2, y2 and all the areas. So here a1 is 1000, y1 is 5, a2 is 1400 and y2 is 80. So whenever you will put the value of a1, y1, a2, y2 and summation of entire area, you will get y bar is equal to 48.75 mm. See, this is the answer for y bar. Y bar is the distance from x-axis. See, what is the formula for x bar? We know that x bar is equal to a1 into x1 plus a2 into x2 upon summation of all the areas, that is a1 plus a2. Again, similarly, we have the value of a1, we have the value of a2, we have the value of x1 and x2. Just we have to put all the values in the formula. By using calculator, you will get the answer. See, 1000 into 50 plus 1400, that is 1400 into 5 upon summation of the area, that is 1000 plus 1400, is equal to 23.75 mm. See, the value of x bar is calculated. Well, we have the value of y bar also. Now we have the value of x bar and y bar. Accordingly, you can proceed and we can calculate the moment of inertia about x axis. We know that to calculate x axis, moment of inertia about x axis for L section, we have to use parallel axis theorem. Here Ixx is equal to Ixx1 plus Ixx2. So Ixx1 is equal to Ig1 plus A1 H1 square and Ixx2 is equal to Ig2 plus A2 into H2 square. Here we have the formulas. For Ig1 we have formula dB cube by 12 plus A1 instead of H1. Already in the previous videos, I have explained how to take H1 distance. While taking XX, we have to take the difference between Y bar and Y1. See, here Y bar minus Y1 is equal to H1. the difference between y bar and y1 is nothing but h1. Here h2, you can see that h2 is nothing but the difference between y bar and y2. See here, y bar and y2. See, already I have taken the problem on moment of inertia about xx axis, so you know that how to calculate ixx. Just the simple formulas are given. According to the formula, you have to put the values. Now we have d b cube by 12 plus a1 in bracket y bar minus y1, the bracket complete, square, plus ig2 is nothing but db cube by 12 plus a2 into h2 square. So a2, and here instead of h2, we have taken the difference between y bar and y2. Press bracket complete, square. You can see this. Here we have the values, base and depth we have. So accordingly, we'll put the values 100 into 10 cube upon 12 plus 1000 into 48 in bracket 48.75 minus 5 bracket complete square. Plus here the value of D, that is 10, value of B, that is 140, value of A2, that is 1400, y bar, we have the value of y bar, that is 48.75 minus y2, that is 80. Here you will get the value of ixx is equal to 5.57 into 10 raised to 6 mm raised to 4. Similarly, we have to calculate moment of inertia about yy axis. While calculating the moment of inertia about yy axis, again the formula will be iyy is equal to iyy1 plus iyy2. For taking iyy1, we have to use parallel axis theorem, that is ig1 plus a1 h1 square plus ig2 plus a2 h2 square. So here for yy axis, the formula will be db cube by 12. You have to use the proper dimensions. See, in the previous case, we have taken h1 as a difference between y bar and y. While taking xx, you have to take difference between y bar and y. See here, y bar and y. But while calculating iyy, you have to take h1 as a difference between x bar and x1. Here you can see h2 is equal to difference between x bar and x2. So the value of iyy, here you will get the value, that is 2.026 into 10 raised to 6 mm raised to 4. And again, we have one more important thing, that is product of inertia. In the product of inertia, you will get Ixy is equal to summation of Axy into summation of I is equal to 1 to n. See, already I have taken the formula for product moment of inertia. You can see ai in bracket xi minus x bar into yi minus y bar. Similarly, here you can see ai is nothing but a1, a2, a3, a4, likewise. So here we have only two areas. So first area, that is 1000 into xi minus x bar. Xi means x1 minus x bar. Here you can see yi minus y bar. So yi, that is phi minus y bar, is 48.75. Plus again ai means a2, you can see here a2 into again xi minus x bar into yi minus y bar. So again here the value will be x2 minus x bar, here y2 minus y bar. While putting the value, you will get the, after putting the value, you will get answer. The answer is minus 2.0855 into 10 raised to 6 mm raised to 4. See, the last and very important point, already we have the formula for principal moment of inertia. The principal moment of inertia, we have 2 points, that is major and one is minimum. So we have the formula, that is Ixx plus Iyy divided by 2 plus for major and minus for minimum. Under root of, in bracket, Ixx minus Iyy divided by 2 bracket complete square plus Ixy square root complete. So we have the value of Ixx, we have the value of Iyy, we have the value of Ixy. Just we have to put all the values in the calci very, very properly. Once you will put the all values very properly, you will get IP max and IP mean, means principal moment of inertia. Here we have the value of Ixx, that is 5.576 into 10 raised to 6 plus 2.026 into 10 raised to 6 upon 2. The Ixx value already we have, minus Iyy, we have the value. Ixy, already we have the value of Ixy also. Just we have to put all the values very properly, you will get principal moment of inertia. If you will put the plus sign here, you will get IP max, means principal moment of inertia maximum. IP mean means me. This is your major, IP max is your major and IP mean is your minor. So here the answer is IP max is equal to 6.483 into 10 raised to 6. Whenever you will put plus value, you will get, you will put the plus sign, you will get IP max, that is major principal moment of inertia. And whenever you will put minus sign here, you will get IP mean, means minor principal moment of inertia. Here the value is 1.12 into 10 raised to 6 mm raised to 4. See, so many problems are there. I have taken university problem related to the principal moment of inertia. You can refer e-content for more problems. Here, just I explained you the first and important problem related to the principal moment of inertia. The next lecture, in the next video, we will see the another topic. Thank you.